The kinetic energy K is equal to half mv square, you can write. Now here by this mv square you are substituting, then half into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into e square by r, then we'll get e square by 8 pi epsilon naught into r. This is the kinetic energy. This is the kinetic energy of the particle. And then potential energy. This potential energy of an electron U is equal to minus E square by 4 pi epsilon naught into R. This is the potential energy of the electron. Then the total energy, if we take, that is a total energy E is equal to this kinetic energy plus potential energy, that is E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into R minus, that is plus, okay, here we have minus, minus by minus E square by 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Then we'll get minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into R. This is the total energy of an electron orbiting around the nucleus. Here E is equal to minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into R, where R is the radius or distance from nucleus to electron. Here we got here minus for the total energy. Here this minus denotes the electron bound to the nucleus. That means the electron bound to the nucleus is denoted with the minus. This is a minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into R. Now by this we can write R is equal to, by this we can write R is equal to E square by 4 pi epsilon naught into M V square, we can write. If we write this V square value, then we'll get a radius of the electron, we'll get. Here, electron revolving around the nucleus in a particular orbits. They are called electron orbits. In that, energy E is equal to minus E square by 8 pi epsilon naught into R. Here, this minus denotes the electron bound to the nucleus. Now the atomic spectra. Here, while studying this atomic spectra, we have now atomic spectra. Atomic spectra. Here, this atomic spectra. Already we know here each and every particle or electrons revolving around the nucleus, and these particles radiates some electromagnetic radiations. Okay, this can release the radiations. These radiations are electromagnetic radiations, and this will have some particular wavelengths of the lines. This can emit some particular lines. Then these are called emission spectra. For example, if these electrons are exciting from one level to another level, then they can absorb, they have to take some energy. That means they can absorb the energy and excite it to another level, then that is called absorption spectra. Here this atomic spectra has a different lines, and for everything it has a particular values. Here this absorption spectra, here for example this is a line. Here in this absorption spectra, spectral lines are forming, and this is a 686 nanometers, and this is the 1875 nanometers. This is the Poisson series. This is Poisson series, and these are the limits for the Poisson series. And if you take a these are the emission spectra, and this line is at, for example, started with 91 nanometers, and this is a 122 nanometers. Like this, this is called a Lyman series. And here, this is again increasing the wavelength. Here we'll get a Balmer series. These are the different spectral series we will get. Now we'll study about the spectral series. Here this spectral series, this spectral series is studied by the 1885, Johann Jakob Balmer studied the spectral series of the hydrogen atom. Here this Jakob Balmer given empirical formula for studying this spectral series. He given the empirical formula, that is 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square, where n is equal to 3, 4, 5 and so on. Here this r is called a Rydberg constant. This r is called a Rydberg constant, and this r is equal to having a value, constant value, 1.097 into 10 power 7 meter inverse. This is the Rydberg constant, and he observed the spectral series for the hydrogen atom, and this is the empirical formula. Here if we take n is equal to 3, if we take n is equal to 3, then he got a wavelength which has a wavelength, that is a 686.3 nanometers. This is a H alpha line. This is called a H alpha line, that is in the red color. He observed this spectral series in the visible region. The 683.3 nanometers he observed in the red color. And in the H beta line, this H beta line he observed in the 482.1 nanometers. This observed in the blue green region. And next he observed this again, this H gamma in the 410.2 nanometers. And like that he got a H infinity. If we substitute this n is equal to infinity, then he got a H infinity, that is a 364 nanometer. Here this is the least wavelength that he observed in the Balmer series. This series is called a Balmer series of the spectral line, spectral series. Here these are the different lines. If we take these different lines, that means different spectrum, if we take, then this is the H alpha line. Here this is the H alpha line. And next if we go, then this is the H beta line. Here this is the H beta line, and here it is a H gamma line. Here this is a H infinity line. These are the spectral series. And here if we take this H alpha, H beta, H gamma, H infinity, then when the wavelength is decreasing,